As soon as I got sent down to the young offenders, they made me a long distance run. They must have thought I had the right build for it. I didn't mind, to tell you the truth. Running has always been a part of my life, especially since I was always running away from the police. I'm a good runner, I'm quick, and I got a big stride as well. The only trouble with that is, no matter how fast I run, and I've done a fair bit of that if I might say so myself, it never stopped me from getting catched by them feds after I robbed that shop.
Liverpool Live TV here on the Playhouse stage with Elliot Barnes-Worrell, who is the... this is difficult. Who was playing the lead role of Colin Smith in The Loneliness of the Long Distance Runner. So how are you doing, sir?
I'm doing well. Just we've got a performance this evening, so I'm just warming up for that. Obviously, I've got a run on this for a little more than half of the play, a 90-minute play. So I do an intense physical warm-up and a vocal warm-up, because while I'm running, I've got to deliver my monologues right to the back of the gallery there.
Right.
So yeah, I'm doing all right. How are you doing?
Okay, yeah, I'm hanging in there. So as part of that, the monologue which you've just done for us,
you
mentioned as part of that, it says that running's a big part of your life. Well, actually, from a personal point of view, is that the same case?
I was a boxer for a long time, and I did Muay Thai as well, and with that, there's a lot of running involved. And then a friend of mine who's a poet that I do poetry with, we're in a collective together, is in a group called the Run Dem Crew, and he was like, oh, we're all a group of creatives and we run the streets of London at night, why don't you come and join us? And so for every Tuesday for about 6 months I ran 10k, and then I found out I got this job and left the Run Dem Crew, started running by myself, not once a week anymore, 4 or 5 times a week, just all in preparation for this job. Yeah.
You're halfway through the tournament production now. So each night, how many miles do you think you do?
Oh God, I think we worked it out. They worked it out, it's about 2K, 2 or 3K, but the newspapers are saying 5 or 4. So I'm not too sure, man. I'm not too sure. Probably about maybe 20K a week, on an average week.
Right.
On a 6-7 show week. Which is... quite a lot to do on stage.
So pretty fit then to do this.
Yeah, now
I
am.
And to remember your lines. I mean, I'm struggling to remember my questions, to be honest.
Yeah, man. You know, delivering lines while running is really difficult. So for the first month of training, I was just running by myself, talking to myself like a crazy person. But luckily we had this treadmill, this incredible 6-meter thing you're running on now.
Yeah.
For the first 6 weeks of... No, for the first... we had 3-week rehearsal period and we had it in the room for 2 weeks, so I got very used to what I was going to be doing on stage in rehearsal room. So there was a lot of messing up and forgetting lines and not quite getting on in time, and now we've perfected it, I guess.
Have you, during any of the shows, have you?
No.
Any
models? No.
Good stuff.
Knock on wood,
yeah.
No.
Excellent. Struggling a bit here. So.
Oh, thank you.
We've had a lot of difficulty filming this with static, shall we say, from the treadmill. How is that? Is that affecting you on the night? Are you getting shocks from your
acting? I get off stage because I get kind of, me and the treadmill become one almost, and I get off stage and I'm covered in static electricity, so I go to touch one of the other characters and I just give them a massive electric shock. But it's not really, it hasn't affected me on stage, like, because I've just been... But we laugh about it afterwards.
So I suppose you literally are charged through each performance then?
Yes, that is a good and terrible pun.
Well, actually, I've got one more question to ask you.
Yes.
You appeared in an episode of Doctor Who, is that right?
I did. There was I met the casting director for Doctor Who, a really lovely man called Andy. And I told him about my love of Doctor Who, and one of my ambitions is to be the next Doctor Who. And he went, well, there's this Olympic special coming up, which is a 5-minute special, and it's just a three-hander, me, the Doctor, and Karen. And he tested out my acting ability, and funnily enough, I was playing a runner as well, so I run into the TARDIS holding a holding the Olympic torch, one of the actual Olympic torches, being chased by a weeping angel. It was thrilling stuff, man, I'll tell you.
So the rest of the tour, after it finishes here on Saturday?
Yeah, we finish
and
on Saturday.
Going
off
around.
To Taunton.
Right.
Taunton, then Winchester, then we finish in Huddersfield. On the 24th of November, that's our last gig.
Right.
So yeah, man, a lot more running.
Well, nice one. Cheers.
Pleasure to meet you, pal.
Thanks for speaking to us.